So last year, we did a production of A Midsummer Night's Dream in drama class. And at the last huge rehearsal, we convinced our technician to play Despacito for the fairy dance instead of the usual track. The fairies ended up T-posing around Titiana, who started Fortnite dancing. I'm sure that Shakespeare would have wanted this.
Do you guys ever think about how weird it would be if Mickey Mouse's name was actually Michael? Like, how weird would it be if one day Minnie called him Michael Mouse because she was so upset with him? Because I think about it sometimes.
Okay, so I've just been informed that Mickey's full name is Michael Theodore Mouse. And that Minnie's is Minerva Mouse. I don't know what to do with this information, but I feel like I know something forbidden now.
Well, now I feel like this is a good time to share the fact that Donald Duck's middle name is Fauntleroy.
What?
Mother bought fruit that smells terrible, so I tried to cover it with perfume and now it's worse. Moral of the story, don't try to cover up an unbearable smell with another unbearable smell. Because instead of canceling out, they just mix together and create another new unbearable smell. Gross.
Oh god, I'm gonna fuck up this pronunciation, but whatever! Pieces of Viking pottery with traces of cats and dog paws seen at the Musée de Normandie at Caen Castle. So back in the day, pets already ruined their owner's artwork. My sis who took the photo?
Ruined? More like made better.
You know, it's very humanizing to imagine some poor potter in the past screaming, "No, bad kitty!" somewhere in Scandinavia.
I mean, if it was ruined, the artisan wouldn't have baked it.
That's a delightful point you just made. This person chose to bake and keep their cat's artistic contribution.
I was in Spain once, and there was a building with a tile that had been laid down in Roman times. It had a dog's paw print. And the thing was that after the dog did the print, the wet tile was dried, and then fired, and then shipped, and then laid.
And for 2,000 years, every person who encountered that tile thought, "Aw, paw print," and kept it. This vast agreement of thousands of people over all these centuries in memory of a dog only one of us could have met.
I loved that tile.
My algebra teacher is pregante and asked my class for baby names, so she called on me and I panicked and said, "Luigi." It was on my phone at art. I read this and laughed out loud and a kid next to me was like, "Who are you texting?" And I panicked and said, "Luigi." Guys, this should be a thing. Every time someone asks you something, you just panic and say, "Luigi."
Oh yeah, Luigi, at the disco. I mean.
Imposters should be able to read ghost chat.
Imagine how much more fun it'd be to go, "Who killed my friend?" and see them shouting at you from beyond the grave. They should also be able to see the ghosts. I already enjoy haunting imposters that kill me, but could you imagine being chased around the ship by angry souls who can do nothing more than slightly inconvenience you and shout at you?
I believe that's Hamlet.
I didn't expect 2020 to be the year of catboys, but at this point it may as well be.
I hate this post. I can't even go look for context. Where do I go? I don't have enough clues. Catboy 2020 doesn't give me helpful information no matter where I search for it. This is so infuriating. Like, I'm a detective that found a body in the back alley of an amusement park, but instead of an ID, it's just a note card with "Nyah" written on it.
I'm sorry, I saw like 3 catboy memes in my dash one weekend and assumed that it meant it was the new meme.
Well, I hate to tell you, Goad.
It is now.
Me writing dialogue. What is man? But a vessel through which a higher entity may see. What is his purpose? Must he find a purpose? We are but stardust, the universe comprehending itself.
Me writing action.
They ran real fast from the Batman, legs hurty.
Me writing action. Her legs pounded against the earth, the familiar jolt grounding her like nothing else could. Magic, gods, royalty, she didn't know anything about that. But running, that's been something she's been doing since day one.
Me writing dialogue.
I don't know, man. What you want to do? I don't know. What do you think? Hey, man. I don't know.
Me writing action. Room go boom! Me writing dialogue.
Nopity nope. That ain't dope.
Ah, the holy trinity of writing.
No, kitten food goes in the bowl, then food goes in you. Aw, you seem to confuse a step.
If I fits, I sits.
Just an October reminder. Werewolves are usually very sore after transforming. Give them a heating pad and some gentle massages, and be sure to keep plenty of food and water on hand. Vampires don't mind the colder weather, so remind them to wear jackets when they go out at night so that they'll blend in better with the cold populace. The monster that lives under your bed likes the smell of candles you burn in your room. Lush forest is the favorite scent. The shadow people actually like nightlights because more light means more shadow. The beast that lives in the woods likes watching you and your friends around the campfire. They like pretending they're part of the group. Mimics love Halloween because their costumes are always the best. This is an important month for witches as well. Supply them with mason jars and remember to put out the moon water for them. And finally, the tree monster that clicks and clacks on your windows doesn't mean to scare you. They just need nail clippers.
You boil up some Mountain Dew, it's gonna be a long night.
You could have said anything else!
Cauldron boil and cauldron bubble. Baja blast of fuel, my treble!
Okay, but I'm really proud of you guys. I feel like I don't say that enough. There are so many ways you keep amazing me. Please remind yourself, we're each of us so familiar with our own quirks and talents that it's so easy for us to view our traits and ourselves as unremarkable when actually the right onlooker would have been startled and impressed. View yourself with as much sympathy as you would a beloved character. The people we love in fiction and in life are as flawed and limited as us, and we love them far more passionately than any theoretically perfect person. You deserve to feel that way about yourself. I promise.
Holy shit, Goat, coming in for the kill.